It's a trap, isn't it, when you really look at it?
What is?
Getting a job, working.
What's a trap?
Well, what's it all about? You read history at school about kings and prime ministers who shape the destiny of countries and empires. You learn about the planets and the stars. You learn about art. They stuff you full of men of vision like Dante, Beethoven, Shakespeare. And when it's all over, they hand you 40 years in a concrete office block, a factory.
See, Ginny Powers was asking about you.
Her?
Her? You're nuts on her.
Yeah, well, you grow up, don't you? Look, listen to what I was saying. Never mind.
What about?
Jobs.
Oh.
There's got to be more to it than that.
Well, not everybody sees it your way.
Yeah, well, that's fine for them that don't then, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Well, your brother seems happy.
Him.
What's he doing?
An apprenticeship at one of those little engineering firms on the trading estate.
Yeah, well, he seems happy.
Makes out he is. To hear him talk, you think they were going to make him king when he qualified? What about you?
I don't know. Your brother's in the Navy.
Left right! Splice them main race! Get your head cut!
Oh, come on. It's not as bad as that now.
Mutiny, Mr. Christian! Mutiny!
You're not really thinking of doing that, are you?
I might. Dave likes it. Well, he gets about it, you know. Does different things.
Like whitewashing coal and scrubbing broom handles. That's different. Why?
Well, wanted to go in the Navy, that's why. I mean, he likes it.
What, scrubbing broom handles?
Nah, get off.
There's one thing I'm not going to do. That's work in an office or factory.
Oh, you know. What time is it?
4:15.
You coming up to the club tonight?
Doubt it.
Oh, well. See you in school tomorrow morning, then.
Yeah.
Oh.
Cheers, Andy.
See ya.
Get your hair cut.
Get yours.
Have a nice day at Stalag 14.
Your tea's in the oven, Joe.
Tom. I said, did you have a nice day?
Oh, I heard. Now listen, Smarty. In 2 years' time, I'll have finished my apprenticeship and got a trade. I shall also have a decent job while you're still buying sweets and comics from the National Assistance the way you're going. Now leave off. I'm hungry.
I'm going to go into the Navy.
What did you say?
I want to find out about going into the Navy.
Let me know when you're going to join, so I can immigrate somewhere safe.
The Navy? But Malcolm, you can't swim.
What will you do in the Navy, son?
Well, I don't know yet.
Now listen to me. I did National Service.
And I could tell you a few stories that would make your toes curl up.
That was 25 years ago.
Do you think things will have changed then?
Well, I shan't know till I find out, shall I?
I like on the ocean way.
What are you going to do in the Navy, Malcolm?
I don't know. I just don't want a 9-to-5 job in an office every day of my life. And I don't fancy getting stuck in a factory for 45 years either.
Well, what's all this 45 years?
Well, that's about as long as I'm going to have to work for, isn't it?
But what, son, will you do in the Navy?
Well, you could finish up in charge of the electronic systems of a Polaris submarine. You could. Obviously, it's unlikely because jobs like that are few and far between, but it's quite conceivable that you could become what we'd call an artificer. In charge of men maintaining the electrical or the mechanical systems of a ship or helicopter, or even a guided weapon system.
I'm only taking 4 O-levels.
And what are they?
English, maths, physics, technical drawing.
Well, that's fine, as long as you get them. We like 4 or 5, but provided you get maths, English, and 1 physics-based science subject, that's fair enough. If you don't, you have to take a special written examination.
How long would it take to become one of those, what you said?
An artificer? Well, you would need to pass a medical and an aptitude test first, then have an interview. But if you go in September, how old will you be then?
Oh, still 16.
Well, if you're good, and you liked it, and you got on well, you could be a petty officer artificer by the time you're 21, and that's not very far away. Remember, you would be a petty officer who'd been through what it is fair to say is one of the best apprenticeships in the country. And with a qualification that is recognised in civilian life as well.
What is that?
The Technician Education Council Diploma. TEC Diploma, as it's usually called. So, in other words, when you leave the Navy, you would leave it fully qualified to do the equivalent sort of job outside.
With 4 O-levels?
Well, we're looking for a lot more than pure academic ability. You don't run a warship on O-level passes, or A-level passes come to that and nothing else. What I'm looking out for is character, strength of purpose, personal attributes which do not necessarily go hand in hand with academic prowess, if you like.
Well?
I'll not make out it's easy, but is there anything worth having that is?
First and second men against the wall, hands locked by your knees. Second and third men, leap up onto their heads, heave him onto the wall, not on his edge, get off him. Use his hands as I've told you. Get him up, both legs straddle the wall. Drag him up by the belt, not by the shoulder.
So you've decided to join up. The apprenticeship is basically 4 years with a further 1 year's advanced technical training after that. And the first year is spent here at HMS Fisgard in Cornwall.
And we're going to compress this charge. So what's the natural thing that's going to happen as we compress any charge in a restricted area?
As fast as you can along the back there, up through the gap. Now just keep your feet on the pole, one hand only for...
The pace is intense. But it has to be intense and cover activities no ordinary apprenticeship would. Because at this early stage, your strength of character has to be tried and tested. Remember, if you're successful, you'll find yourself in charge and with a lot more responsibility than you would have in civilian industry at the same
age. Keep it going. What's the dressing? Get your dressing.
Can't look around. That's good for you.
You're not anticipating order. Anticipation of an order is deadly for you. Because it's blisters on your feet.
Transition from civilian life to service life isn't always easy. It would take you a while to adjust from the comforts of home to the more organized, disciplined routine of service life. And it's my job, as your division officer, together with the divisional staff, to help you make that adjustment. We live very close to you, we're in constant daily contact with you, and we soon get to know you very well. We can soon become aware if you have a problem and if you're not quite happy. And if that's the case, whether the problem be to do with your training or to do with some family problem at home, then it's our job to try and help you get over it. We don't expect anybody to be able to sort out all the problems by themselves. So if you have a problem, come to us and it's our job to try and help you put it right.
Yes, that's coming on nicely.
Fisgard's main purpose, apart from that of giving you your very basic trade training and of getting you accustomed to naval life generally, is to find out which of two primary trade areas you're suited to, the mechanical side or the electrical side. And then secondly, to find out whether you're likely to be more at home working with ships or with aircraft. So, on the evidence of their aptitudes, Fizgard sorts apprentices into three basic groups. Those who will specialise in the propulsion machinery of a ship and all the electrics that go with it. Those who will specialise in weapon systems, which includes radar, sonar and navigational aids. And those who will apply their mechanical and electrical skills to aircraft maintenance. Towards the end of the year at Fizgard, there is a dance, which has the reputation of being one of the big local attractions. The final event of that year is a passing out parade of apprentices attended by families and friends. You leave HMS Fizgard and go to one of three specialist training establishments according to what you're going to specialise in. The mechanical side, the aeronautical side, or, as in Malcolm's case, the weapons side at HMS Collingwood in Hampshire. And it's to your specialist establishment that you will be attached for the remaining 4 years of your course.
Just okay.
It's not easy.
Yeah. Ah, is there anything
worse? I know. No.
Yeah. Should be used to it by now. I mean, it's been 2 years.
I'm going to sea after this, Lee.
Yeah? How long for?
A year.
Wow. That's long. You want to stick your bag in a boat?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. They push you hard at Collingwood. I'm itching to get my hands on a bit of working radar and actually do something.
So, what have you been wasting your time at so far, then?
The first two terms at Collingwood, mate, are straight terms of academic work and nothing else.
It's a bit heavy, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And there's an exam at the end of that, so I'm always drop out there. But after that, you certainly know something. But you do get to get your hands on some equipment, and it's pretty sophisticated, and a lot of it.
What sort of equipment?
Well, it depends what you're specialising in.
Well, I thought you specialised in all that electrical stuff.
No way. Well, there's too much of it. No, you can work on computers that feed information to radar, things like that. All the electrics inside missile launchers, torpedoes, gun mountings, that's another group. I'm doing radio electrics.
What, just radio?
That does include radar, sonar and a lot of electronic equipment.
Oh. What will you be when you're finished?
What will it be? Well, when I'm finished, I'm in charge.
Of what?
I have a lot of equipment and the blokes that help service it. I diagnose the problem and then supervise them putting it right.
Get you.
It's a fact. And then there's a mate of mine gone to another place. He's doing a mechanical apprenticeship. Ship's engines, diesels, turbines, all that. And then there's aircraft. There's another group specialises in aircraft electrics and mechanics. There's plenty to choose from, young man, if you ever want out from your little job at the public library. No 9 to 5.
Yeah.
Nothing's changed much.
No. Still sleep in hammocks, do you?
Yeah, we sling them from the wall or sleep on the deck. Oh, floor. 20 men to a room, nowhere to put anything, dark little dungeons with no light. Not much different from Nelson's day, really. It's very primitive. It's
So, what's new here then?
Like you said, nothing much. They pull rotten buildings down and put rotten ones up.
You know that new type of top thing? Well, you know, I like that.
Yeah, but how long's that sort of thing going to last?
Well, I don't know, but it looks good, doesn't it?
Well, now, I'm done. There's silly everyone wearing it, isn't it? Half of them are too fat anyway.
I'm not too fat.
You're about the one about the Irish parachute. Yeah. I was leaning back.
Hello, sir.
Oh, the Field Marshal.
How's the war?
Up to me neck in Mac and missiles. How's the slimming?
Oh, it's equal to the thing they teach you in the Air Force, is it?
Not the Air Force, Sylvia, the Army.
No, it's not. It's Navy.
Hello, he speaks.
Now, shut up.
Have some more.
Shut up.
Making a man of you, are they?
Don't suppose you get much chance of it down the library, do you?
What?
Talking. Hey, do you sleep in hammocks and sing sea shanties?
We'll make the keel bowl.
Put on play little pipes and scrub the decks and drink rum. Why haven't you got a parrot on your shoulder, eh?
Peace to mate, peace to mate.
What a very nice couple of girls you are.
Hey, do you remember John Phillips?
With the big ears, yeah.
They weren't big.
Well, they stuck out then.
Anyway, yeah.
He's working for an advertising agency.
Doing what?
He's working in the television studio.
So?
So it's a job with a bit of something about him, and it's a bit different, isn't
it? He doesn't have to earn a lot of money, too.
Well, that's very nice for him then, isn't it?
Meaning?
Meaning if he's happy for his life to revolve around fairy cakes and lavender cleaners, that's nice for him. But not for me, thanks.
But why the Navy, of all things?
Why not?
Why, Malcolm?
One, I wanted to learn a trade.
Well, you could do that anywhere around here.
Two, I didn't want a 9-to-5 job, or any job where the neighbours could tell the time by the click of my front gate. Three, I wanted to see at least a bit of the world at someone else's expense. Four, I wanted a job that was secure. Five, where promotion was certain. Not possible, certain. Six, a job which wasn't a dead end. Because even after I've qualified, if I decide I want to try and become an officer or take a course in anything that will help me get further, I can. And the Navy will help me. Finally, I'm not in the Navy for life if I don't want to be. They don't have press gangs these days. And when I leave, I can come back and work in industry like your old man or mine with the qualifications I'll have got. That apart, I suppose it was just careless fancy, really. Talking of which, the only drawback is they don't have women on ships.
Ha.
Yes.
Isn't it a shame how big-headed some people can get? Hey! Don't they really have birds in the Navy?
Wrens.
No, be serious. Don't they really have birds in the Navy?
I told you, wrens. They're called wrens.
Wrens?
All those apprentices who are required for dog watch instruction will muster at 16:30 today. You'll go smartly away to your instruction. Right, carry on, senior apprentice.
Apprentices.
Whatever type of artificer you train to be, you spend at least a year in field training. On a naval air station, if you become an air artificer apprentice, at sea, if you become a marine engineer, or weapons engineer artificer apprentice. This is your first experience of living and working on board ship. And however big a ship may look alongside in harbour, it seems a lot smaller than that when it's alone in the middle of the ocean, and you have to share it with a few hundred other men.
Yeah. What do you think it's for?
Check the mechanical linkage for
an underwater explosion, isn't it? If we get an underwater explosion, moves the rudder, it'll try and move the mechanical linkage, so that spring will take up the shock.
It's also your first real opportunity to see working at first hand mechanical and electrical systems which have so far been only theory. Your days are very full, though this is something you'll be well used to by now if you've come this far. Nevertheless, you do actually get some time to relax. Even so, a certain amount of work has to be done on your own. Work which will be checked both while you're at sea from day to day and checked again as a whole when you get back to your shore establishment.
My father works in an engineering firm. They've got apprentices there. And I tell him about what we do, and he tells me about what the apprentices there do. And in comparison, we're a lot better off, very much better off, in pay and especially in actual training itself, in what we're taught and how we're taught.
It has to be good. When you become a qualified artificer in a ship at sea, you're in your own little world, and there's not much to fall back on in an emergency by your own skill, initiative, and judgment.
Through a diaphragm, and yeah. By doing that, increasing or decreasing.
As a marine engineer artificer, you could be responsible for actually keeping the ship moving.
Right, Jim, go down and check out that diesel. Keep me informed as to what's happening. Diesel's trip. Just gonna start another.
The ship's propulsion is four jet engines, two of which are Olympus, the kind of power Concorde. These are your responsibility.
Okay, start the Port Olympus. Start the Port Olympus. Bridge SCC, the port time has tripped. We're starting the Port Olympus.
Port Olympus going up to.
Roger. Deselect port time.
Here, Mark. How are you, Dawson speaking?
We've lost our
92
rotation and we need
it
in a hurry. Could you get
someone over
there, please? Yeah, okay, I'll be there in a second.
As a weapons engineer artificer, you could be responsible for maintaining and repairing the radar, without which, beyond the range of a pair of binoculars, the ship is blind. Which is the kind of work Malcolm will soon be qualified to do. And as with artificers in other branches, it involves not just being in charge of maintenance and fault diagnosis, but also helping and guiding those under him.
I suspect these two output transistors. I'd like you to strip it down and see if you can check them out, fix it if necessary.
And both marine and weapons artificers play a vital role in submarines, a service in which today one-third of all seagoing artificers serve. And as an air artificer, you could be responsible for the mechanical and electrical efficiency of this aircraft and its weapons. You the one who says it's safe to fly. You into whose hands the pilot puts his life.
Right. What were the tail angles like?
No. Inboards were correct, the outboards were slightly incorrect. We've brought them all down. Should be all right then.
There we go. Fine.
Thank you. Thanks, Doctor.
Gained a lot of skills that you wouldn't have had outside, probably not physical sort of skills, but you've got a deeper understanding of everyone else.
I really enjoyed it, you know. I didn't think it would be as good as this when I joined up to start with. And I'm pleased with what we've done. I think I've learned a lot in the last 2.5 years, more than I would have done if I'd been in Civvy Street.
And when your field training is finished, you go back to your shore establishment to complete your advanced technical training. From where you emerge, as a fully qualified artificer. Without them, the Navy could not function. Its ships would very soon grind to a halt, and its aircraft fall from the sky. It isn't easy. A lot depends on the effort you yourself are prepared to put into it. But as with everything else in life, it is what you make.
Hello.
Claire.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I suppose you can swim now.
You look super.
Thank you.
How's Tony?
Oh, I've got another problem there. Shall I get it?
Yeah.
Bloody fed up. What do you think? Bloody fed up. Cheers. Well, it's dead man's shoes, isn't it? You get no further to a Scroggsy retires or Perkinson kicks a bucket, will you? Or me. Or we go somewhere else where it's different, but the same. Anyway, getting back to what I was saying in the paper. Without qualifications, they'd take us up to the age of 33. Artificer. Oh, very funny. Jet planes, computers, electronics, weapon systems, and promotion certain. Never mind how I know. 8:30, yeah. Who? Bring her if you like.
Changing your job.
But me, mate? No. Single-minded ambition, me. You should know that.
Dead men's shoes, though.
What?
Can I see?
Crossword, mate. Crossword.
Come on.
Your mental grasp. And another thing.
A life on the ocean wave. A life on the ocean wave. A life on the ocean wave.